Ladies and gentlemen, you are watching yet another episode of Eric Lee Miss Shenanigans of 1977. And it's Saturday night, and you know what that means. It's time for the AEW Collision Event Center. And now, here's the man who's always been on a collision course with his brain half the time, Eric M. Lima. Thank you very much, Mr. Announcer, sir. Well, hello there, everyone. Welcome to yet another episode of Eric Lee Miss Shenanigans of 1977. This is episode number 1,328 of the show, April the 7th, 2024, 9:11 a.m. Good morning, everyone. I'm officially on vacation for another week. And I know there's lots of things that were happening over the weekend. WrestleMania happened last night. It was a great WrestleMania. It was a good and decent WrestleMania. But now we all know the stipulation for the Universal title match between Cody Rhodes and Roman Reigns. That would be bloodline rules. That means anything goes. And as one of my subscribers commented, that expect a lot of insanity. I believe that is going to be the case. Lots of surprises could be happening at this tonight's WrestleMania. So Cody Rhodes, I'm sure he's going to be preparing himself for battle. I'm sure that he's going to go all out. A little thing of note, I was going to do. Now, I finished watching AEW. I watched AEW Collision last night into the wee hours of the morning. But I was too tired to do a video then. And I figured I'd do a video now because I'm on vacation all this week. And so I want to have plenty of time. Trying to get myself waking up in the morning before I go to church and praise and worship the Lord and listen to the Word. And that's very important thing in my life. But, however, I want to get this video over with so I can head up there and I can catch up on my videos, catch up on everything. Because I know it's a big WrestleMania tonight. And I'm going to get my thoughts on the Stand and Deliver, the announcement that a Women's North American Championship being announced. I think it's a huge deal in the women's division in NXT. I believe, you know, it gives more women an opportunity for another championship. But, you know, you got, and the women's division in NXT has been, to me, the backbone of NXT for quite a long time. And they all thought, and I would like to see a women's intercontinental title for the main roster or a women's United States title. You know, lots of women there will get a huge opportunity. Imagine that be a Triple Crown or a Grand Slam champion, you know. And Here's the ultimate deal, though, here. With Rhea Ripley's victory over Becky Lynch last night, Rhea Ripley is now another woman that has beaten all four horsewomen in a matchup. And that is a huge deal. And, you know, that is an accomplishment in itself. Now, we know that the Intercontinental title is in the hands of Sami Zayn now, defeating Gunther after 667 days, reigning Intercontinental Champion. Will Gunther demand a rematch, or will Chad Gable be the first one to step up and say, hey, you owe me one, and I'm sure Sami Zayn would love to give Gunther a shot, give Chad Gable a shot at the Intercontinental title. Well, we know Gunther may have a rematch set in place, and if he wins the title back, he'll continue breaking the record for the most days as Intercontinental Champion. I mean, just you know, it's just a huge, huge deal. Now, since Rhea Ripley has retained the women's title, we don't know what's going to happen to her. Also, you know, Kathy Kelly interviewed Trish Stratus. He says, mother has yet to meet mommy. Well, is Trish Stratus eyeing Rhea Ripley as her next opponent? You never know what's going to happen. So, but since Rhea Ripley does retain the title, who is he going to go after? Who is going to be the next line to try to stop her? I mean, with the draft coming up and there could be some changes, who knows? Io Sky goes over the Raw and challenges Rhea, maybe? I don't know. So we'll have to find out tomorrow night, the Raw after WrestleMania, of course. So let's talk about AEW Collision. I'm just talking just to make sure I get the video. Like I said, AEW Collision was supposed to come on at 11:30, but it didn't come on until like quarter to midnight, and I was up late watching it. So you know, Jordan's like concerned of my sleep hours. I said, hey, tomorrow off, don't worry about it. So I figured I'd do it now. The tag team title semifinals, FTR versus Top Flight. The winning team will face the Young Bucks of Dynasty to crown new AEW World Tag Team Champions. And FTR did end up winning that matchup. The promo about the newest member of the Elite, Kazuchika Okada, that is going to, the Rainmaker, who is a new Continental Champion. Who's, and it looks like Impact, who defeated Encore Moore, seems like he wants Okada for that Continental title. I wouldn't be surprised if Okada accepts it. I see that match happening in AEW Dynasty. Renee Paquette interviewed Bryan Danielson talking about the matchup against Will Ospreay. And, Bryan Danielson seems to be humbled. And he's probably looking forward to this match for a long time. That match will happen at Dynasty. Meanwhile, Cook and Chris Jericho took on Shane Taylor Promotions. Lee Moriarty and Shane Taylor. Hook. Hook and Jericho won the matchup, but Anthony Ogogo jumped both Hook and Jericho, and after the matchup, and is joined up with Shane Taylor Promotions. That's a huge deal, and that's a huge get. And you have somebody as powerful as Anthony Ogogo. Watch out for him. Dustin Rhodes addresses his career here, and he. Well, apparently he's taking a cue after his brother. Basically wants to finish his story. But he's challenged Samoa Joe for the AEW World Championship. Samoa Joe later on has a response. I'll get to that. Trios matchup. Christopher Daniels, Matt Sydal, and the Bounty Hunter Brian Keith went up against the House of Black, the team of Malakai Black, Buddy Matthews, the luckiest man on the face of this earth, if you know what I mean, and Brody King. And winning that matchup is the House of Black. And then they have Adam Copeland. Looks like House of Black trying to jump off for him. And then Adam Copeland and FTR all get involved. And the Young Bucks also got involved, knowing that FTR would face them in the tag team title final. And then they will show footage of what happened at All In London. Let me explain to you something. Those two Beavis and Butthead Dingle Nuts, they're going to probably kind of troll us and say, ha-ha, we just this goofy video of them being idiots and all that, or probably making a mockery of what happened and all, really what really happened all in. They're trying to really get WWE and AEW to a war. Well, Dave Meltzer, it's all your fault, dude. Thanks a lot, you dummy. I was hoping that one day AEW and WWE would work together, and since WWE's under a new era, you know, the post-McMahon era, as I like to call it. But the fact of the matter is this, you know. And poor Tony Khan. You know, I know a lot of people saying, you know, Tony Khan's this, Tony Khan's that. I feel Tony Khan, you know. I'm not feeling Tony Khan. I feel bad for Tony Khan. Here's why. All right, it's because the fact of the matter is that, yeah, he's a wrestling fan. He's just being a fan. I think the Young Bucks are trying to force Tony Khan down. They're trying to be the ones in charge. I think, to me, the Young Bucks are intimidating Tony Khan behind the scenes. Saying, we know wrestling, you don't, we'll handle things. And that's been a problem. That could be the problem, you know. And Tony Khan is reverted to being a fan. Tony Khan's got to step up. He needs to start stepping up. I'm sorry. If I was Tony Khan's father, I would sit him down and say, listen, son, I bought you this company. You need to be the man in charge. You need to show these people, including the Young Bucks, not that you're letting the Young Bucks run things, you know, letting the inmates run the asylum. You need to start stepping up and stepping in charge. You can't be doing this. You know, if Cody Rhodes had not left AEW, then Cody Rhodes would start putting smoke down, because Cody Rhodes knows the business better than the Young Bucks. And I'll tell you one, the Young Bucks are trying to satisfy their good buddy, Dave Meltzer. I blame Dave Meltzer for all this crap. You know something? I like AEW, but Dave Meltzer has really influenced the Young Bucks to be arrogant jerks. And that's why I call them Beavis and Butthead Dingle Nuts. They're a couple of Dingle Nuts, the Young Bucks. Moving on. Lexi Nair interviewed Hook and Jericho. And then Hook, you know, Jericho's ticked off of what Shane Taylor Promotions did to him. It's just two of us. And Hook goes, I got somebody. Looks over. Katsuyori Shibata. Volunteers team up. And then he goes, Jericho's like, that's a good idea. Bet. And Katsuyori Shibata, I like him. He doesn't speak a lot of English, so he depends on Google Translate and a little Alexa to help him out with that. I think it was a good idea. Any foreign wrestler doesn't know to speak English, hey, you know, type in any form, Google Translate, and hold it to the microphone. Hey, I think it's a good idea. You know? Shibata means business, though. Lexi Nair and interviews Rocky Romero. Romero's issuing a challenge. Roderick Strong decided to challenge him to an international title eliminator matchup. And Yuka Sakazaki making a return against the infantry's Trish Adora. And Sakazaki ended up winning the matchup. And Serena Deen comes out and applauds Sakazaki. I think Serena Deen wants to test herself against the young Joshi wrestler. Matt Menard and Daniel Garcia cut a promo, issuing challenges, and they said, let's get going. I'm ready for a fight. Let's have at it. Then, Julia Hart, Claudio Castagnoli took on The Butcher. Castagnoli won the matchup. Julia Hart addresses Will Nightingale and Mercedes Moné. As you know, Julia Hart will be defending her TBS title against Will Nightingale at AEW Dynasty. Samoa Joe did respond to Dustin Rhodes. He said, I will not accept your challenge for the title, but if it's a fight you want, I'll give you a fight. But I'll sweeten the pot. You beat me, I'll give you a title shot. Hey, that's seem like a fair deal. I'm sure Dustin Rhodes probably understands. Alright. And then the main event, Penta El Zierro, who will be challenging Adam Copeland for the TNT title this coming Wednesday, went up against Commander. This was a heck of a matchup. Alex Abrahantes, who's always been in both men's court, he's always checking up on Commander, making sure he's okay and all that, did not get involved in the matchup. Penta won the matchup, and he checked up on Commander. A little sportsmanship. And in the end, though, Adam Copeland came out, got a smile on his face, and Adam Copeland knows what he will be up against this coming Monday, this coming Wednesday on Dynamite. Well, that is all the time we have on this show. Episode 1328 of Eric Lemmy Shenanigans in 1977 is complete. Later on this afternoon, I will be joining my good friend Jordy Scow as we prepare for WrestleMania 40 Sunday night. The big one, as they say. And you know the drill, and I will run down the card for you one more time in this case. Sunday. Universal title will be on the line. Roman Reigns defense against Cody Rhodes in a Bloodline rules match. That means anything goes. World heavyweight title on the line. Seth Rollins to defend against Drew McIntyre. The women's title on the line. Damage Control did not pick up the victory last night, so it's up to Io Sky to try to write that wrong as she defends her title against Bayley. Meanwhile, the United States title on the line in a triple threat. Logan Paul defending against Kevin Owens and Randy Orton. And then a Philly street fight, Bobby Lashley and the Street Profits, a.k.a. The Pride, will go up against Final Testament, Karrion Kross with the Authors of Pain, with Paul Ellering and Scarlett Bordeaux in their corner. Meanwhile, The Pride will have B-Fab in their corner. And finally, LA Knight goes one-on-one with AJ Styles. That's tonight. I already gave you my picture prediction, so that's all the time we have on the show. And episode 1328 is complete. See you on the next episode. And until that next episode comes rolling around, Mr. Announcer, please take us home. That is all for today's episode. This is your announcer speaking for Eric Lemmy Shenanigans of 1977. A big beefy E, do it for Bob Saget Productions. And in association with Arabian Bofa Telepictures and Distribution, thank you for watching today's episode. Tune in next time for another episode of Eric Lemmy Shenanigans of 1977. Goodbye for now.